Copy, hands on, watch me celebrate. I'm cocky, I do my dance, jump in the stands. No man, a man, oh, deal with the hands. Thought he could guard me, I ruin they plans. I do what I want, they do what they can. Got it on smash, put on the gas. I will not crash, honey, y'all dash, 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 yeah. They can't catch a. Way too advanced to be playing with amateurs. They on attack when I tackle like damager. They react and play it back on the camera. Hot boy, just consider me flammable. Sure shot, I got all the intangibles. Need a leash, I'm a beast, I'm an animal. Eat the competition up like a Hannibal. Know the game like I wrote up the manual. I do weekly what you do on the annual. MVP, that decision unanimous. Big dogs, I don't think they can handle this. Battlefield, it's just me and my warriors. Guaranteed we emerge victorious. Years blessed, sweat, tears, it's glorious. I remember when they all was ignoring us. Dash, got it on, smash, foot on the gas. I will not crash, they will not stop me. Tenfold, copy, end zone, watch me celebrate. I'm cocky, I do my dance, jump in the stands. No man, a man, oh, deal with the hands. Thought he could guard me, I ruin they plans. I do what I want, they do what they can. Got it on smash, put on the gas. I will not crash, honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash. They slip on the team that they owe me. Give me that. I need a ring and a trophy. I say I'm the best cause I am. It's no need in keeping it low key. I can carve out the D like a turkey. I run straight through the D like a train. This year we ain't taking no losses. It's all about making the game. I hear a lot of trash talk. He call himself making a name. I put on the jets to cause some regret even letting him stay in the game. See, my route took a tumble. Next time be humble. I'm the lion in the jungle. You just trying not to fumble. Rumble, young man, rumble. Never slip nor stumble. I take off, poof, magic. Now watch me juke through the traffic. Footwork fantastic, dominating every facet. Treat the pocket like plastic, here come the blitz, pass it. Got it on smash, put on the gas. I will not crash, honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash, honey, y'all dash.
We are just to the west of you, Coach, on the Gulf Coast of Florida at Raymond James Stadium, just north of downtown Tampa. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with the Arizona Cardinals. The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. This one taken from the 7. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. This is Peyton Barber. He led them in rushing a season ago. Give him 3 there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they were hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Here's the first carry for Dwayne Washington. And he'll take this one for about 4 up to the 40.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They'll run with a former Tar Heel, T.J. Logan. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down. So on fourth down, out comes the Bucs free agent signee Bradley Pinion to punt. Back deep, Patrick Peterson. And this ball's going to be down now right at the 10-yard line. Good spot.
I absolutely love the flexibility of these punters. Their leg drive, able to get it way up in the air, and that allows their punt team to get down there and down it inside the 10 because they've had some time.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 from back at their own 10-yard line. This is David Johnson, the former All-Pro, and not much there at all as he'll get this only up to about the 11. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
On second down now, it's Johnson, and he'll get this one up to about his 14. Only gets 3 yards there on the heels of the one-yard pickup. Sets up third and 6. A lot of people felt Johnson was a little misused during what was a disappointing 2018. 940 yards on the ground, 7 touchdowns. Great for most, but not the season Johnson was hoping for. And he said this offseason, there are a lot of good running backs in the NFL, but I'm the best. So now he's trying to prove it, hoping to get back to the production that sent him to the Pro Bowl in 2016. That would certainly help his rookie quarterback. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. A fourth round pick in 2018, Chase Edmonds with a carry. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. In on the stop, Vernon Hargraves.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
On second down, this is Edmonds. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. Now Johnson. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. Now on second and 13, Murray. He's got it to Williams. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 38-yard line.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in this paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? A first down carry here for Johnson. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
Throwing is Murray on third down. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning, hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed. If there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. And Gonzalez puts this one through. And the Cardinals have the first points. It's 3-0. So the opening drive does yield points. Maybe not the 7 they wanted, but they'll take the 3.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the 3.
Yeah, they had 3 first downs and 3 points. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the outside of the playoff picture looking in. So a lot to fight for.
Yeah, and wasn't it interesting in our meeting with the coaching staff that they all made sure to let us know, we know where we are right now, but the playoffs don't start tomorrow. We still got some time, and they plan on putting it together, formulating a streak, get the whole month of December still left to play. They think they can get in.
And they made it very obvious to us that there's no playoff talk in the locker room right now. It's win this game and look to next week.
Excellent focus.
7 yards there and a first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 30. Jameis to throw it. And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down. The linebacker Jordan Hicks flying in there for the sack. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. On second down, Barber. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. It's a 7-yard gain that gets him back to the original line of scrimmage. 3rd and 10.
Peyton Barber, a surprise workhorse for the Buccaneers in 2018. I don't think they expected him to have 234 carries, but he certainly felt like he could carry the load and just carried it there for a nice gain.
The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up 3rd and 10. On third down, it's Logan. He's got the first down and more past midfield. A big gain there on 3rd and long. 51 yards.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. They run with Logan. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. Not quite the success they had last play. This one goes for 3 yards.
I'm wondering, partner, if they might need to sub him out for a play or two, because after that long run he just had on the previous play, he might not have all of his breath back.
Yeah, and they went right back to that well. Different result. Winston gives to Barber. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Peyton Barber, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Bucs have taken the lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Go!
ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. They'll run it with Johnson. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Let's go, baby. Let's go.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. The 305-pound Ndamukong Suh fighting the path to the QB there. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. If you get 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Murray. And he's got Fitzgerald. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That's a first down with a cherry on top, 31 yards. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. They go back to the ground with Johnson, and he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. It was Jason Pierre-Paul who was able to get him down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Now Murray throwing on second down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Levante David making his presence felt in the backfield.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Now that last sack puts Murray and the Cards in a tough spot, third and long. Murray with a third and long. Eluding the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
Terrific coverage in the end zone that time. Forced him out of the pocket to his right. I thought maybe try and run it there, but no one came open for him. Nice job by the defense of not getting out of their lanes.
They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. And out of bounds, sailed over, looked like right near the pylon. This one's going to be perfect. Directional kicking at its finest, right down at the 1 yard line. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. They scored a touchdown the last time they had the football, but things are going to be a little bit more difficult this time.
No, certainly, because where they're starting, the goal isn't even thinking about a touchdown at this point. They're thinking about field position. A couple of first downs in order to give some room for their punter and maybe flip the field position for their defense.
Now a give right side. Logan, and they'll get him down right at around the 11-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
Two minutes to play in this first half, 7-3, our score. We remind remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll send you across state to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have all the stats and all the scores from games going on during another busy Sunday in the National Football League. Now a play fake here on first down. Looking for Perriman there. He's got him. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Ready. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Barber on first and 10. And some room to run now. And he does take it in for the touchdown, but a flag on the field, and I don't think this is going to stand.
Yeah, don't put the points on the board just yet.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. They'll run with Barber here, right side. A good productive run there on first down. He winds up getting 8.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
On second and 12, Winston flushed out right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. Winston needing a big play after the sack as he leads the Bucs up on third and long. On the carry, it's Logan. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. And well done here. That one will kick out of bounds at about the 8-yard line. So they'll play the field position game here as a very nice punt is going to pin them back.
Yeah, it's almost like watching a game of tennis, or do you prefer ping pong, you know, back and forth like that? That definitely was excellent, wasn't it?
Ready to go with their next drive and at the offense. Inside of a minute left in the half. Does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do or, I guess, don't do on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more is who I've got running my football team out on the field. And the weapons around him. Can he make a play? Can he get into someone that we're going to trust to take care of the ball? If that's the case, I might push it a little bit here and try and get something before the half runs out.
On second down, Johnson. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. Once again, they'll keep it on the ground. And they will get to him behind the line, but the clock continues to tick down. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave them with a fourth down. Here's Andy Lee now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game. As we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando, there standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Thank you.
teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
Yeah, they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. Now a 10th carry for Johnson. And he'll grab a gain of five out of this up to the 41-yard line.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
From the 41, Murray. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Vita Vea able to record his fifth sack of the season.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
To throw, it's Murray. And able to find Kirk complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The Cardinal passing game dialed in now. First down. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. They'll run on first down, Edmonds. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. On second and 12, Murray. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. It's been this way most of the afternoon, hasn't it? This secondary really put this receiving core on lockdown.
Listen, they've worked together like a basketball team that's playing excellent defense. Great communication, doesn't matter whether it's man or zone. And especially against deep balls, as we saw there, they're not giving up anything to him.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything that warranted a flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. Excellent placement. And off that bounce, Charles, I didn't know where it was going to go. It can be an inexact science as to where they place it, but they say the 2-yard line.
Yeah, I don't know how they really determined that. And let's face it, at the end of that play, one side's going to be happy. The other team's going to be unhappy. So what do they do, shorten the hypotenuse? I mean, how do they figure that out? You know that stuff. You're the smart guy.
No, that's you, partner. They'll run on first down. It's Logan. And they take this up near the 30 before he's taken down. A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
They go back to the ground, this time Barber. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It's a gain of 11, and the Bucs have a first down. Make that now two runs in a row that have netted them great results.
And it doesn't matter what kind of blocking scheme they're using, gap scheme, power scheme, zone running, they are finding people in those gaps and moving them and creating nice space for their runners.
A lane opens up that time as he'll be brought down just short of a first after a gain of about nine. Give him nine on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and one. The last run got nine. That leaves him with second and a yard.
58 to Mike, 58, 58 to Mike.
I smell fear in it.
They'll try to throw now. Winston. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Terrell Suggs, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number seven for him on the year. On third down, it's Logan. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! T.J. Logan, his sixth touchdown of the season as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense.
These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline, because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Back to the air on second down, it's Murray. His throw incomplete. Larry Fitzgerald was the intended target. Third down here.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Murray going to throw. And that is incomplete.
Now we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off.
Here's the veteran punter, Lee, as he sends this one away. And this will be down just on the other side of midfield. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession.
They had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time, they get at least a little bit more of a cushion with field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot right now and try to cut down the length of the drive.
No room to be had there on the first down run, as he's lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
We ain't giving them nothing today.
Once again, it's Barber. And he'll get it across midfield and down into Cardinal territory.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Ready. Blue ready. Switch.
They'll try and run here with Barber. 14 yards there and a Buccaneer first down.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said...
Under a heavy rush. flash, and down he goes. Clinton McDonald in there to get him. It's a loss of five.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
Three, triple three.
Third and long for Winston. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Terrell Suggs make that now eight sacks for him on the season.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long, why are you calling play action?
Because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to deal with pass protection and the line blocking. But to me, it seems silly.
Yeah, well, they're silly, and it leads to a play action sack.
These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right, baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Well, at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
Back now in Tampa. It's Cardinal football, but they trail here as we get set to bring you the fourth and final quarter. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five.
Check, check.
Here's Johnson, and they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. Officially, it will go as a one-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. The Cardinals on third down. They've converted three times and eight chances. This will be third and six. From the gun on third down, Murray. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by the rookie linebacker from LSU, Devin White. And he will score. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
This is taken at the three. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. Murray trying again after the pick six. That ball complete to Isabella. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. A well-executed 22-yard gain. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Levante David. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line.
Andy Isabella was the intended target. That's one of those interceptions watching from up here that quarterback wide receiver just looked a little out of sync.
They did look a little out of sync, and yeah, they're going to examine that when they get to the sidelines, and they'll talk about it throughout next week when they watch the tape. But the guy who's going to be there for him, really in his ear, is his center, because that's a special relationship for a rookie quarterback. Your center handles your line calls. He gets everyone in the proper position to block. He'll be the first guy back to pick you up after you've been knocked down. And that's the guy you watch the extra film with and try and learn the league.
Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Now that turnover might just about do it here. Fourth quarter, the lead that you got, they can just run the football, run the clock.
Exactly right. They played smart. Couple of first downs.
A big seam, and he might go all the way. And he does take it in for the touchdown, but a flag on the field, and I don't think this is going to stand.
Yeah, don't put the points on the board just yet.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations.
Rashad Perriman off to the races. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Rashad Perriman. His ninth touchdown of the season as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Here's Gay now to add the extra point. And that'll increase their lead to 28. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This is taken at the three. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Mike, 45.
I know he ain't got it.
Check nickel.
Looking to throw on second down. Murray, he's going to fire one deep left. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 38. And they have possession. And they have it at the 38-yard line. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And, Charles, we are in the midst of a very one-sided affair. I think this is where you and I have to fill a little bit. You want to regale us with old stories of your childhood in New Paltz, New York?
I don't think anyone wants to hear that, but this is a perfect time for us to start listing MVP candidates, right? The best teams we've seen so far this year, the best games that we've called thus far, how we anticipate the season unfolding. We can go in so many different directions because the game certainly not taking us there.
Oh, I hear the remotes clicking off right now. A nice job to get eight there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a third and two coming up.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home. Just like that.
They run again with Logan. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. First down, Tampa Bay there, a gain of 13.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this.
Got a man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. 36 yards on the play. Boy, another big play late here for an offense, Charles, that certainly has had its fair share of big plays.
Coverage has been a problem all game long, and I would say that going along with that has been confidence, because even if they had the right coverage, they've still dented them, and now it's been a real issue for them during this game.
Second and goal from inside the five. Now Winston. And that's going to be intercepted. The all-pro corner, Patrick Peterson. Now they get a fourth quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other, but it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over. They begin the drive with Johnson. And he'll go down at the 26 following a gain of 6.
Well, they did throw interceptions on their last two drives, so no surprise at all they decided to start it with a running. A little bit surprised, though, that they got as much out of it as they did.
Yeah, decent little gain. Puts them in a pretty good spot for second down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. They go to Johnson again. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Here's Johnson. He's been busy this afternoon. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Second and 13. Murray steps away to his left. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 27 yards there, a first down. Well, we know that Murray can run the football. He rushed for 1,000 yards during his final year at Oklahoma, better than 7 yards per carry. And Cliff Kingsbury says, I trust him running the football. This is a guy that has known his quarterback since 2012 when Murray was a sophomore in high school. Kingsbury was in the OC at Texas A&M. He would go on to take the Texas Tech job, but the two maintained a great relationship. Both are from Texas, both quarterbacks, and both with fathers heavily involved in their football careers. Clicking, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Devin White leading the surge there as he drops him for a loss of 6. And you hate to say it with a rookie quarterback. He's done some good things, but overall, looked a little bit overwhelmed back there, hasn't he?
He certainly has. But in his defense, he hadn't had a lot of time to throw the football. You like the way I said that? In his defense.
In his defense. I got it.
You see what I did there?
Yeah, he needs better protection, that's for sure. And he'll be taken down right around the 41-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain that gets him back to the original line of scrimmage, 3rd and 10.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
On 3rd down, Murray. And that will be incomplete. Another incompletion. You know, it's a wonder he's still moving around back there the number of times he's been sacked.
Yeah, he's staying out there, isn't he? And you don't think about it much in a game like this, but he's showing incredible leadership. Still competing, still fighting, not taking himself out of a ball game that appears lost.
The Cardinals, worst in the NFL, 6 of 16 on 4th down last year, but they'll try it here. Murray and company going for it on 4th. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the 4th. On 1st and 10, here's Murray, flush to his right. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their 2nd, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ballgame. Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Murray fighting, lost the football. And now with 6 seconds remaining, they're going to burn their final timeout. Throw deep downfield, and this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go. No move to get the offense off the field here. They've converted once on this drive. On 4th, they'll go again and try it once more. Murray, one final try. And that will be incomplete. They were going for a consolation TD, but it was not to be. And time.